Hey guys, how's it going? Brad here, and I'm back for another vlog video. And I'm going to try to keep these videos short from now on. Unless I'm doing an unboxing, those videos will run a bit long. But I'm noticing that I tend to ramble on in my videos, so I'm going to try to keep them a bit shorter. I'll keep them between like 5 and 10 minutes, I guess. And but there are quite a few things that have been going on this week. I've been gaming a lot, and I've been working a lot, and I've been looking forward to playing the Anthem demo. If any of you are gamers that are currently watching this, you probably know that there's an Anthem demo going on this week, and this weekend, and I'm recording this on Sunday morning, so I've been playing it the last 2 days, so the Friday evening and all Saturday, and I must admit, it's a pretty solid game. I'm really enjoying it. I'm not going to compare it to other genres. Other people are saying it's like Destiny and it's like Mass Effect and blah, 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 blah. I don't like doing that. Anthem is a great game. It had some login issues for the demo. There are some issues with the missions when you're playing it. It does tend to crash, but that's what demos are. That's what they do. And I noticed like some of the things I experienced, they've already got, like they've already kind of adjusted and patched a bit. And there was one server restart while I was playing, and that seemed to clear up quite a few things. The load screens tend to hang from time to time. The interface is a little bit unusual to get used to. I will get used to it, though. It's a little bit different than what I'm used to, and it's not intuitive because I'm not used to that. The way it's like, it's all on angles. So like the whole interface is like, if you remember, if you had the Xbox 360, when they had the sliding menus, it kind of reminds me a bit of that. That's not a game comparison. That's more of a UI comparison, just the way it flips. And I'm like, okay, I'm getting used to this. I kind of remember this, but the game is really good. It is beautiful and it plays so well. And I'm just being very patient with people around me. I've dropped a few F-bombs when somebody has done something really stupid. But it actually plays really well. I'm actually really, really enjoying it. And I'm glad I pre-ordered it. I definitely will play the game. I want to see where the story will lead and how deep the game goes. I genuinely want to see that. But yeah, so far, impression is really good. I am actually really, really excited for this game. I can't wait. And it's going to be, what, 2 weeks away? I think it's February 22nd it comes out. Don't quote me on that. But, and then I think you get an early start if you're an Origin Pro VIP member or whatever they call it. I don't know if everybody else gets early access as well. I've got the Dawn Edition, so maybe I will get early access. I haven't really checked up on that. But on that front this weekend, yeah, I've been working a lot this whole week. I've been watching the Star Trek Discovery, the second season. If you haven't watched that or you're apprehensive to watch the second season, it's very different from season one already. It's very exciting. There's a lot of mystery and intrigue already. I'm very curious where they're going with this season. So it's quite cool. You might have seen in the news that like Spock has been introduced in the season and everything, but he hasn't been quite introduced yet, but I'm not going to give you too many spoilers in that regard. What else? There's also something coming up for me, but I can't talk about it yet. I still have to find out when I can talk about it, and I will specifically try to seek out that information. But it is exciting, and I can't wait, and it's coming soon. I can't even say when. But I am very excited for it, and I can't wait to see what happens, so I'm very excited. But yeah, I wish I could tell you more, but until I get more information, I can't really say much. But yeah, other than that, I'm going to try to keep these videos short. But yeah, that's pretty much all that's been going on. I've been playing Anthem all weekend. Today, it's just after 1 on Sunday when I've been recording this, so I've got to record 7 gaming videos. So that I can post Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And there's going to be 2 videos per day, but then there's a third one. So I may do 3 in one day and then 2 on Wednesday and Friday. But we shall see. It all depends on how much I can get done. Not only do you have to, if you're a YouTuber or if you've recorded videos before for YouTube, you may realize that sometimes you record a video and it's great. You can do it in one take. I'm going to try to do this in one take so there's no edits. And but then you find that when you do go into the editing process, you start noticing issues, and you have to start editing or putting in, B rolls or stuff like that in order to kind of adjust or make it more exciting or deal with some issue that screwed up in your video. That happens a lot with gaming. I've become pretty quick with editing my videos, so that's not too bad. Usually, my edits for my videos take maybe 15 minutes. I remember when I first started, it took me 12 hours to edit my first video, and I'm not joking, it took 12 hours. 16 if you include kind of teaching myself how to use Premiere Pro. So it was kind of like a 4 hours of like trial and error, and then I literally spent 12 hours editing a 3 hour gaming video, trying to chop it down to 5 minutes using all the best clips. But yeah, that was my first attempt. But now I've become much better. I try to do everything in one take. If I don't get it in one take, I edit out really quick, put in a fade, and then move on. And then I have to encode, and the encoding takes forever. So it usually takes about an hour and a half per video for encoding. And I have a good computer, but well, I have a pretty damn good computer actually, but it's interesting why it takes so long to encode. I wish, I guess it's heavily CPU oriented, but I wish processing or encoding videos would be much shorter. I like to see them be as short for encoding as it is to upload to YouTube. So I have a broadband connect, a high-end broadband connection. So when I upload a 12 gig video to YouTube, because I oversample my videos, when I upload a 12 gig video, it may take a couple of minutes. So I would love to see encoding take a couple of minutes. That would be wonderful. So when I start encoding all these videos today, I've got to do all my playthroughs and then do all the edits and then do all the encodings all in one batch. So I just walk away from my computer and I let it encode. I don't have a second computer to do all my encoding for me. I don't have the room for it and I don't want to spend the money on a second computer. But yeah, with that, I'm pretty much done for the week. Hopefully there will be stuff that's more exciting. Well, there is stuff that's exciting that's coming up, but I can't talk about. But yeah, that's about it. But thank you very much for watching, and hopefully I will see you soon. And I hope you're having a great week. Thanks a lot, and I'll see you again soon. Thank you very much for hanging in there to the end of the video. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell button so you know when I post the next video. And don't forget to comment and let me know what you thought of the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.